What exactly makes you self-made, right? So there's been a debate about this in recent years. How we define it at Forbes, and of course, everyone's free to define it their own way, but the way we define it here is it's essentially self-made or inherited, right? We know that no one in the world creates a multi-hundred million dollar or multi-billion dollar company all by themselves. No one does. Bill Gates did not create Microsoft by himself. You know, Jeff Bezos did not create Amazon by himself. Maybe you got some money from your family to help friends and family to start a company, but that's what we mean by self-made. Does it make sense? The cutoff to make the list this year was have a net worth of $150 million. There are a number of women in tech, which is interesting because tech has a reputation for not promoting women. We may just have the outliers, the few successful folks, but we have people like Ruth Porat, who's the chief financial officer of Google and Alphabet. Sarah Friar, who's the CEO of Nextdoor, who prior to becoming the CEO of Nextdoor was the chief financial officer at Square. Another fun newcomer is snowboard company co-founder Donna Carpenter. She and her husband, Jake Burton Carpenter, who passed away last year, co-founded Burton Snowboards and pretty much transformed the snowboarding industry, like helped turn snowboarding into like a real sport and not just something people were experimenting with. Another category of newcomers is our celebrities. So we have folks like Maria Sharapova, the multi-time championship tennis player, who's also gotten into business. She's got a candy company called Sugarpova, and she's invested in some of her earnings from her lifetime into Supergoop, the sunscreen and skincare company. She owns something like 10% of that company. Another very well-known celebrity to watchers of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, we have Kris Jenner has joined the list, the mom to Kylie Jenner and to Kim Kardashian West. Another celebrity who joins the list is Lady Gaga, who's also into cosmetics. She launched a makeup line last year called House Laboratories. And that's helped to put her on her list on top of her earnings from singing and being in the movies. One big thing that we had to face as we were putting this list together was what is the impact of the pandemic? And many of these companies, many of the companies started or helped being created by the women on the list, you know, are publicly traded companies. So we can actually see how the stock is doing in relation to what's going on in the world. We used stock prices from September 11th to measure the net worths for the list. But many of them are private, right? And they don't, and private companies sometimes will tell us, will disclose their revenues, right, for the end of the year. So we might have had 2019 revenues for things, but of course the pandemic didn't start in the United States anyway until 2020. But there are a handful of billionaires that will be like, hey, you missed me, I should be on your list, right? But that's really the rare thing. And I would say that I can't think of a woman billionaire ever. I mean, I don't mean to stereotype, but just like, it's probably more of a male trait to be like, hey, I'm really successful and you don't have me on your list. Whereas, I can't think of any like woman who's a PR person or who directly reached out to us and say, I belong on your list. It just doesn't work that way. So it's on us to find these people. And we may be missing people.